Hello everyone and welcome to the stream. Another week, another adventure in No Man's Sky. And an update, because I'm just waiting for the game to get patched. But it's done now, so we can hopefully start. There we go. Get into the game. Hope everyone's doing all right. Had a good... Bright. Had a good week. I had an all right week. That's better. Making sure that the microphone is on and that you guys can hear me. Yeah, so trying to figure out what we're going to do this week. I'm going to go to my trusty old creative mode here. I think I might build out that power plant that we started last week. Maybe check in on some stuff. Oh, I remember there's something that I wanted to do last week and I completely forgot. It has to do with the garage where Tracy and Stuart work. Yes, I'm starting to remember all the names of the weirdo in absentia characters that I've made up for this base. But yeah, so, hey, look at that. Apparently we're playing Portal Knights. I should probably make additional scenes for that, but let's just fix that now. Where's the logo? All done. Yeah, so No Man's Sky, not Portal Knights today. Portal Knights is actually something I started doing on Sunday mornings with Kid Codifier, who's our 8-year-old squad leader, on Saturday mornings. So Kid and I have been building out a massive school that he first started designing and building for his sister. And then we kind of started building out and actually ransacking mostly Fort Finch, if any of you have played Portal Knights, for stuff. So, yep. All right. And where are we going to end up? Perfect. So there's the garage we added on last week. And still have the rest of our base over here. And there's the power generation station we started last week as well, which I feel like I'm going to need to build out a little bit more. Tracy and Stuart's desks. And this dangerous pallet. But the thing that I want to add, and what I'm probably going to add, I'm going to have to figure out where I can put it, is the... whatchamacallit? Specialist station for the Exocraft terminal. Now, I might want to put it in here. I think it'll fit if I remove that stuff. Kind of like what I've set up, but I might just move some stuff around. So let's actually do that. Let's just get rid of some of this stuff here. And then rework this corner so that we can have, of course, oh. There we go. Gonna put you kind of in the middle, a little bit off to one side. Align you and try to get you as back. No, it's too far. There we go. That's good. I mean, the wheels get clipped at the top there a bit, but I don't think you'll really notice. And then we go back to decoration and interior, and we start adding some stuff back in. Mostly the industrial things. So I'm going locker. And then just some more cases, containers. I actually like the way that looks with the red light there. Can I put this out here? I wonder if the door be in the way. Oh. Oops. That one doesn't look so good when it clips the door. So I'll just make sure it is out of the way of the door. And then start putting some boxes on those shelves. Some pallets here too. Offset things a little bit just to make them feel like they're a little different. Right. Getting close to getting finished with this area, I think. It gets rid of the nice red glow, though. Alright, let's just leave it like that. Maybe I'll just make a tiny one. No, it does that weird thing with the odd wall. Alright. So then, maybe just... I can't resize that. Where's that going? The wire here, I really don't know where it's going. Oh, maybe that's for the... Yeah. All right, well, it's add some. Where is it? No. Technology. Oh, is there power? Power switches. Nice big red button. And then some wires. Or did I want that to be a switch? I don't know why that light went out. All right, let's decouple all this. Oh, because I just don't have any power. All right, I'll have to fix this later. I guess it's more important than I thought to get that power station up and running. So, I am going to switch views here. Much better. Those lights are not on. What? Why are these out? I thought these generate power. Offline. Oh, these are the mineral extractors. Dope! It's not my power plant. I gotta make that power plant. I got very confused. Alright. So, that means we need to go... Where was it? Power was off that direction. All right, let's go take the vehicle from the bay again. I feel like that mineral station is going to need a redesign. Before I leave, go. All right. So let's grab our nomad. We know it's over here somewhere. Oh, we overshot it quite a bit too. Okay, so it's not as far as I thought. Oh, hey, big guy. All right, well, let's see how we're doing. Local field 72. No. Flattening out a little bit of an area here because we are going to have to build into the side of the mountain here. Perfect. All right. So now we are going to build, and I think I'm going to use concrete for this, a platform. To build our power stations on. One of the things I was thinking of for our mining station that's over there, we might want to build one of these underwater as well, because then we can build up. And apparently I haven't analyzed everything here yet. Alright, let's just get rid of this guy. So we have our platform. We're going to need I'm just planning ahead here. I'm going to build a little bit of a facility around this. Again, because we're trying to do somewhat of a realism build. So not just creating platforms so that, or support for this platform, but also creating a little bit of a, like a facility that would go with it. Let's see if this works. No, it does not. That's too bad. Oddly enough, that works. Looks a bit weird, but that kind of works as like a support. All right, so let's add our other supports here, and I think I'm gonna use red. Maybe we don't need those after all. So here I might be able to use, because they disappear so quickly, is that going to fit? No. So I'm just going to build out a couple of floors here. Went the wrong way. So a couple of smaller pieces here. And then here as well. I'd actually use the narrower staircase on that first one we built as well. So that can do this. So let's see if this works now. There's one. And there's two. Ugh. that's what's going on. Gotta put two on this end. I mean, I could have just gone all with the larger piece, but that requires some rework, so let's just skip that. Alright, so we're going to have some more work to do underneath here. But let's start building our power stations so that we can get those up and running. Power. Here we go. One thing that's nice about these floors is that it also lets you kind of align the power stations. Or anything that you place on them, actually. They're not perfectly aligned. It does a nice job of keeping them organized. All right. Let's see what that gives us for power. So what I'm going to do here, is fall off. All right, so going back to structures, basic concrete. Where's this wall? Small. Oh, not yet. And then go small. Will not let me build there.
Weather warning. Incoming storm.
So you can see what I'm doing here. I'm building the same type of um, battery room, essentially. Alright, so now we go over tech, power, batteries. What I'll do is I'll just build a few first. And I'm going to actually make good use of this one wall where we couldn't build another room. So let's do that first. Start connecting all our stations. And as usual, the weather is not cooperating with us. It is cold and freezing, and I can't see very well. Makes me want to just find a paradise plant to build this stuff on. But I like the story. I like the idea that Morgan and Stuart and Tracy are all stuck on this frozen ice ball of a planet, and they are just trying to make do. I feel like someone's going to have to be stationed out here at the power plant. Let's grab this guy. And which one was he best attached to? Probably this one over here. Shabam. So, generating 206, where is it? Okay. So I feel like this might get expanded quite a bit, because it's probably our best way of generating, but maybe this is enough. Now we just need to create some more of those power lines. Structures. Concrete. More unidentified minerals. I guess I haven't been keeping track of cataloging on this planet. But that's mostly because I've just been building this stuff. Alright. Where can I build? How about just here? Oh, this is interesting. So there's a good spot here that's kind of like between everything. So rather than just build a standard tower, I'm going to build something a little bit more substantial. Or maybe not. Maybe I'll just... it's simple. Oh, that's floating. Hey, Pripyat, how's it going? Some lamps. I was using the green ones. I'll just keep using those. So you don't actually need to use these lights. You can actually just connect a wire and then connect another wire to that wire. But I like having them connect to something. So I use the lights because then I can also see when power is out. And I think it gives a nice sort of little visual touch to the towers. All right, come on. Go, and now we go over to our wire. I can probably just connect one of these directly. See, look how good that looks with the little green light up there. I hadn't thought of this before, but I could actually put another light on the bottom one that's a different color and have power coming from somewhere else and have two separate power networks. Alright, will this make it, or will it be too far? Nice. All right. Let's grab another one from here. As part of our little realism build, I am going to, and you'll notice that I can actually build other stuff here now. Like before, this would have been out of reach of my base, but once you start stringing things along, you can actually increase the size of, like the footprint size of your base quite substantially. So I'm just putting some boxes here, make it look like someone was out here doing some work. Oh, that box is horrible. Maybe I should do it somewhere where it's more flat. I'll just put it a little bit further away from the, like right here. A little bit further away from the post itself. So I'm just making it, again, feel a little bit lived in. I could probably add some more cargo containers, kind of like how we had at our landing site. Maybe I'll just leave one crate up here. No, that also looks horrible. Alright, well, too bad for you. Crate only go over where it's flat. Alright, so now we should have powered everything, and our little mining operation here should be functioning again. Yep, looks like it's doing its job. So now we have power. We can go back to the power plant, work on that, or we can work on some mining operation, but I think we'll work on the power plant first. Not 100% sure what to do over here yet. I got a good little temporary thing going, but we'll figure it out. Alright. So we got power. We're gonna need to put a little bit more structure on this guy, but let's just take a look at it from down here and see what it looks like. That big guy sure has massive pounding footsteps. Alright. Come on, there we go. Cannot build. Oh, right. Floors before stairs. Oh, don't go at all. Those will, though. Oh, sorry, buddies. I feel like maybe this needs to get blocked in. That might look good. Opposite of what we were doing with the other one. Oh, come on. Oh boy. Because I want to kind of keep this floor open. I like how that aligns with the stairs. It's too bad that I can't do one of these here. That would be really cool. But alas, not to be. All right, so let's do that. Good. All right. So we'll have that there. And then here we will use, I think, just pure concrete walls. There they are. And just block this in. Smaller one. Because we kind of messed up how these are set up. There we go. It's all blocked off. Oof. They're all at 100%, so I need to make more. So never mind that plan that I had for corner, I'm just gonna make it all batteries now. I These days, I'm gonna have to come up with a better plan for a battery station. And you know what? Maybe that day is today. What I'm going to do is try to build some kind of industrial looking massive underground room with some catwalks to get around, and then batteries on every floor. And we'll see if I can make that room here. Red on the interior. Go back to structures, concrete, grab the floor. Actually, I'll go the standard gray. I just went past it, didn't I? For this first bit. Oh, right. Damn it. This is all messed up. This will fix things, I hope. And then maybe what I'll do is take a book from the garage. Build some big garage doors. And then back to our floors. Come on. Yeah, this is all gonna have to change, isn't it? Alright, well, let's get rid of this stuff first. just put some windows up there to make that kind of like an observation area. Might still be outside, but could also be designed to let light in. This might be a little bit more difficult than I thought. I want to dig down. Yeah, it's going to keep doing that. I will probably have to use my mind, my terrain manipulator, to blast this out a bit. It might actually look kind of cool keeping some of this rock stuff in here. Like they just built this room out of a cave. Always do that. That does actually look kind of cool. We'll see. Not sure if I'll keep that. Need more floor. Getting rid of some of the strenuous rock. Now the one thing that's going to happen with these floors is that the whatchamacallit, the battery, or the, you know, the battery stations don't snap into position here with these. So it's not really a problem, it just means it's going to be messier. Yeah, I like this idea of keeping it filled with rock. And then using a bunch of these arch pieces to make it like scaffolding, structural support. And then just adding a boatload of batteries. And extending this so that we can have even more batteries. Like a pillar in the middle here. All right. So now the thing is, because the batteries don't snap, we're also going to have to connect them all, which will be a bit of a pain. So ideally, it would have been better to use the small room, but I wanted this specific look, so. I think I'll just place them all and then come back and add power cables. So I'm probably going overboard quite a bit, but it's about the aesthetic as well as the functionality. This is definitely not going to be an efficiency build, but this will look somewhat like a real power plant. A real sci-fi power plant. This is going to be a lot of batteries. Probably want to increase the power output.
Weather warning. Incoming storm.
All right. Getting pretty good, getting pretty close to having enough. That should probably do. I'll leave that space open. I'll add some boxes, crates, and such. Gotta connect all of these. It's a lot of connections. But at least I don't have to deal with that storm outside. I think some of these I put a little bit too close together and it makes it difficult to connect them, if not impossible. But I think we're doing okay now. Hey Phantom, thanks so much for the follow. That is greatly appreciated. Oh, here, Beer Pong, you're here too. Awesome. TK Cultist, how's it going? Thanks for the follow. Always good to have cultists as followers. I think cultists know a thing or two about being followers. So it's probably something that cultists put on their resume. Maybe our buddy who works here, Morgan. I've been outlining the lives of the in absentia staff of this facility. So maybe Morgan, who works in the garage, is a bit of a cultist. And he put that on his resume as strong skills in following orders, experience as cultist, have led small groups of cult followers on expeditions successfully. Oh, Fandom's one of your D&D crew. That's awesome. Very cool. Thanks for bringing in some buds. So let me tell you a little bit about this stream, or about this show, this stream show. I gotta connect that to power somewhere. Hold on. Let's grab that guy. So what I'm doing here, so this is my creative mode, No Man's Sky. I call it the realism build, because I'm trying to make everything look realistic and lived in. So we just built this power plant. It's not quite done, but I built a little bit of a structure. And I have the electromagnetic generators on the roof. And then through this observatory, you can see into the sort of like warehousey battery spot. But I can show you, I'll make an example here of what I mean by making it look realistic. Holy geesh balls. Yeah, so Prip, TK, you guys are old friends. Let's see. Yeah, so I will go in and I'll make sure that everything has kind of that lived-in look. There's lights. I actually made some like sleeping quarters. And I just realized I made sleeping quarters for two of the I made two sleeping quarters, but we have three fake staff that I've made up, so maybe I need to make another sleeping quarter somewhere. Otherwise, somebody's not getting a good naps, or maybe they just have to share one. All right, so just putting in some stuff here. Again, just want to make it look lived in and used. So I'll like add crates and lights and stuff. Boo. All right, so let's see what else we got here. Some sort of workstation, maybe over here. So what I'll do is try to get that as close to the wall as possible. One next to it. And then, where is it? I went the wrong way. Scale that beauty up. So it's just about decorating, adding some interior design. Oh, Fandom has to sleep? No problem. You get your sleep. But thanks for the subscription. I mean the follow. Damn terms, getting all the YouTube and Twitch stuff mixed up. But come on back, Roy Harper, Harper, Roy Harper. Hello. Thanks for the follow. That's awesome. Always happy to have new followers to the stream. All right. So just adding stuff in here, making it look like it is an actual constructed base and not just empty buildings. Let's let's get a light over here. Maybe I'll just put this guy up here for now. Oh, you don't like, it doesn't like that. There we go. These ones will have to be plugged in. Luckily, I have a device on the base. Oh, you're one of Mr. Craig's friends. That's cool. Welcome. Welcome to the channel and the stream and all those things. And wires. I have to put some more down there after. This is a big room to fill out. Let's just do the stuff up here first. More interior. I feel like maybe some kind of little table thing here. Some more piled up resources, containers on this side. Phantom Rescue. Some lockers would be good too. And now I have no space for them. You know what? Let's put those lockers in first. Side by each. Maybe they have workman's overalls here, worker overalls. All right, now we can put some of this stuff back in. Again, just trying to put a lot of boxes and stuff to make it look like it's used. There'll be some clutter. Doing some stuff a little bit haphazardly. So yeah, this just is, hey Bishop, how's it going? I've built out a power plant because my base was out of power. My base is too big. I think that's twice in just as many streams that I've used that reference. Need some, well, maybe I'll put like some banners up here. Is that light gonna... Oh no, that looks great. I definitely need some more boxes over here. And some more on the floor over here, I think. Maybe this guy will go here. Is that? I'm doing all right. I had a semi-productive day and I went into this strange place called the outside world. I ventured out of the apartment, which I don't do very often. And so that was exciting. I thought it was exciting. Tech storage. There are some crates here too. Another way. Oh, that's really stuck in the wall, isn't it? So now, this is starting to look a lot more used and lived in. One thing that I like to do when they're not plugged in is go to lights and grab a bunch of these light stands, make them black, and just kind of stick them around here. Again, almost more like this is storage. They probably get in the way. Maybe Stuart placed them here and then Morgan came by and is like, damn it, can you like move these? I can't get it in my locker. But Stuart's too lazy to do that. So Morgan's gonna have to figure it out for himself. Did I get those names reversed now? I think I did. I'm going to leave these doors unpowered for now. Let's take a little bit of a tour of the rest of the base. So this is the power plant. So far, this is the newest build. I've built all these little towers. Whoa! I've built all these little towers here. So if I turn on build mode, you can see all the wires that go between them. I use those lights as connectors. And then way over there, you can kind of see... There's a mining operation underwater there, and those are the collection bins. So now I've got a bunch of power for everything. Where's my nomad? There it is. So let's go back to the garage. So there's the main base. There's my little garage. popping in. That's a good parking job. Oh, and we are still out of power. What now? Am I not generating enough power? Oh, maybe this thing's not attached yet. There was an issue earlier. No. Oh, wait. My lights are not attached. There we go. I forgot that I had detached everything. All right, so here's the garage. And again, you can see that sort of lived-in build. Everything looks. There's the safety hazard of the pallet right by the door. And here are Tracy and Stuart's desks. Tracy did some graffiti up here that no one has noticed yet. And her chair squeaks. And she doesn't like it as much as Stuart's. Our landing pad, which is basically where we started when I first built this base. And the whole idea of the base was exemplified in this idea that normally these landing pads just sort of stick out of wherever the door is on this tiny little piece, and they just float there, which looks really unstable. So I manually went underneath and sort of, without being able to stick it on, built this structure to make it look like it's part of it. And then I still owe you an email. Oh, yes, I do. Oh, I forgot. I owe you an email about last session of D&D. I will get to it. Here's my underground solar farm, which makes no sense. But solar farm, battery, lots of stuff going on there. Ooh. Let's see. Here we've got two sleeping quarters. These little bubbles. Again, lots of stuff in them. Use a lot of scale to get things to fit and look like they're part of the structure. No, no secrets. Don't worry, Prip. No D&D secrets. It's all just stuff I gotta ask. Oh, and I always fall down this ladder hole. It's the worst ladder hole. So this is our little eating area and kitchenette and waiting area for the space station. And then this is our lab that we created. And we've learned that the scientists are messy and not very safety conscious because this is the eye washing station and they put a bunch of stuff in the way. And before beer pong showed up last week, we actually discovered that, or we were talking about how they probably play beer pong with science beakers. So when beer pong showed up, I was like, oh, cool. His name reflects the weird beer pong game we were talking about. These are our shipping containers, one of which was turned into a micro habitat. So there's like a bed. Oh yeah, there is a third bed. So maybe Morgan has to sleep out here. He likes it because of the privacy, but it is a bit cold. And then, again, more crates everywhere. And this is our little biodome farm. Oh no! Bishop's saying their secrets. So yeah. That's the base. And let's head back over to our power station and finish building it out. Or, maybe I should build more landing pads for the plane, our starship, so that we can fly. But for now, I'll just park this guy right here. I'll have to find or discover or decide if I want to put like outer walls on this thing or if I want to just finish it off and make it look like it's got scaffolding structure. I do like this sort of rocky interior. So maybe what we can do now is just add some more lights, and I'm going to stick with the red theme here. And power all this up. It's a bit messy, but it works. And then more crates. Crates everywhere. I was cleaning up my hobby room of way back when we played that little Warhammer Fantasy Battle Map based campaign thing. Oh yeah, I remember that. That was a lot of fun. You're talking about the in-character smack talk. What were we talking about? The what was it called? Warhammer Empires? Little plastic map thing? Is that what you're talking about? Or are you talking about when we just took the map of the old world? Ah, the old world. Warhammer old world. Always so much fun.
Incoming storm.
And this planet has... He's talking to me. Oh. Fine. I'm not part of the conversation. So, maybe I'm going to use some of these and make some rusty. These are pretty big, but I'll make a couple of rusty whatchamacallits. What are these? Barrels. And then we'll go over to decals and grab some numbers. E6. And then good old 401. And if anyone knows what I'm referencing there, then high fives to you. Oh man, this place gets misty. That looks pretty cool though. Alright, let's grab some more boxes and these guys. Table. I know that there's a table. There is the table. I found the table. Alright, put a table in. Maybe I'll add a chair to that. But first, some more boxes. Whoa, that one's way too big for down here. that's too big. Is nice. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with how this is turning out. And once the storm clears, everything goes back to normal down here. Adding again more piled up junk so that it looks good from every angle. I'm going to leave this middle part clear, although I could actually add more stuff to it, but I think this looks pretty good as is right now. It's workable. And then if I jump down here, yeah, so, oh, hi beetle thing. Should I actually grab one of those as a pet someday? Yeah, I've been going for about 2 hours. I think I might be calling it pretty shortly. Let's just finish up the structural supports for our power plant sort of installation. Space cow is getting in the way. So I'm building some of these basically underground because otherwise there'll be a little bit of a gap, and those always drive me bonkers. Come on, there we go. Oh, what are you sending me here? So one of those golden demon comps very fondly. Ah, yeah. All right, Bishop, thanks for showing up. Really appreciate that the support. Have a good rest. I will send you that email. Oh, I remember this guy. I will send you that email. I promise. I will do it shortly. I will do it tonight. After this stream and after I eat some food. Come on. There we go. Those back in. All right. So it has structural support there. There. That's not good. Locks the stairs. So we'll do it this way. Almost there. Come on. No, not purple. And then one more structural support. And then just some railings because we don't want to get sued if someone falls off the edge. And then the other thing I could do is put even more boxes out here, but I think we'll save that for next time. So next time maybe we will start off here and finish detailing the outside. Still should have some kind of little walkway to get in. And then we can move over to the actual mining facility. There we go. There's our power plant station. All right. Well, everyone, thanks so much for being a part of the stream. Just before we log off, and I think I will actually raid somebody. Oh yeah, Magma Tracks. But I just wanted to talk about two shows I got going on. So they're the two new shows. I got a full schedule up on Twitch, but Prip and I have started playing some DLC from Sniper Elite 4. And we're doing that on Thursdays. That's taking over from the previous stream that we were doing of Ghosts of Tsushima. And then starting on Tuesday, I'm going to be doing a co-op playthrough with my buddy Tamargar on a segment we're calling It Takes Tuesdays. And we're going to be playing through A Way Out, which is a fun co-op prison break game. Prip and I played it before, and I'm kind of looking forward to getting through it with Tamargar, see how what he thinks of it. Oh yeah, I got my nice shirt on. Very happy about that. All right, well, thanks again. I'm going to find somebody that we can actually raid now. Not Magma Tracks, because I don't believe Magma Tracks is streaming, although that would be pretty cool if he was. Let's see, who could use some folks? I know who could use some folks. It's a good friend of mine. Give me that Quan. He is playing Final Fantasy. So let's go check out what Quan's up to. Again, thanks so much, everybody. I'm going to start the raid here. And I will see you all next time. Let's see, what's tomorrow? Tomorrow's Saturday, 8-year-old squad leader. So 11 a.m. Eastern, that's when Prip, Kid Codifier, and I will be in Ghost Recon. Should be a lot of fun. All right, guys, have a good night. I'm going to start the raid now, and I will see you next time.